Hi friends, I'm JJ Abraham. Welcome to English Grammar Classes. Today we are going to discuss about the use and formation of simple present. First of all, let's start with the use of simple future. Here we would discuss the use of simple future with two auxiliary forms. They are will and shall. First of all, let's see the use of will, wherever we use will. First case, to predict the future for future facts and for the things that are less certain. So something that is possible to happen, something that is guessed to happen in future, they are usually discussed in simple future tense. Usually a simple future tense is not used to give any assurance or any guarantee that is so sure to happen in future. Because future's surety is based upon the present time and especially the time where we live. So that's why simple present is used, or even present continuous tense can be used to say about the future actions. Out of that, simple future can give a fixed or a fixed plan or a decision, and present continuous will give a future action that is possible to happen, the arrangement as well as a plan as well as the desire of the person, something that is about to take place, can be stated with the help of present continuous tense. If we use will, that is used to predict the future, something that is possible to happen. The sun will rise at 7 a.m. So according to the place as well as the climate and the weather, usually this prediction is done. I think the conservatives will win the next election. So there is a possibility of winning or losing a particular election by a political party. So based on the situation, by evaluating the present scenario, present situation, we usually predict the same. Likewise, usually we say that it will rain today. So how this prediction is done? By seeing the dark clouds, we say the same, that there is a chance of rain. So that means when we state a sentence in simple future, it gives a meaning that something that is possible to happen in future. Second one, promise, request, refusals or offers. Actually, this use is applicable when will is used as a modal auxiliary. So when we take the case of will or shall, shall is used with the subjects I and we, with the normal case, and will is used with the rest of the subjects. If we interchange the same, it will give something different meaning. For example, if you say that she will come tomorrow, that means the sentence means that there's a possibility of her arrival tomorrow. But if you say that she shall come tomorrow, there the speaker gives a promise for the person, but there is no requirement, or it is not compulsory that the person himself or herself should give a promise. So but for her, someone else would be giving an impression or a promise, or it can be done to say about the refusal too. So if you say that I won't do it, that is a refusal. I am not ready to do it, or I am reluctant to do so. Then if you say that I will help you with your homeworks, that means I am just giving you an offer, a promise, so that I am willing, I am ready to do a homework. Then will you give me a hand? So I am just asking your help. That is the normal use. So the request, when a request is done, that can be done with the help of will directly. If you, the case that I intend to get your help, so I just want to get an offer from you, in that sense you can ask in different way. Shall I expect a hand from you, or shall you help me? So in that respect, in that case, we can see that that's a varied or different use, and there will or shall changes as a modal auxiliary. Please go with the video of modal auxiliary for the further reference. Then the next use is to talk about something that we want to do in future. So I'm cold. Then the other person offers, I'll close the window. So something that is offered over there. That bag looks heavy. I'll help you with it. So in that case also that is considered to be an offer. So something that we want to do or something that we intend to do, that intention can be said with the help of will or shall. The next one, in the first conditional and the other sentences that have conditional feeling, we use will. If it is, if it doesn't rain, we will go to the park. Then if he comes tomorrow, we will do it. Let's arrive early. That will give us time to relax. So in these three cases, we can see that the condition is stated with the help of simple present and the result obtained from the same is stated in simple future. So for that purpose, we use simple future tense. The next one is the use of shall. To get someone's opinion, especially for offers and suggestion, we use shall. Shall I open the window? So in the first instance, instance we can see that the person said that I feel cold. Then the other person offered that he would close the window by using will. The same way, shall also can be used to give an offer. Shall I open the window? That means, do you want me to open the window? This is the meaning. Then if we just ask the question like that, where shall we go tonight? What's your opinion? That's what I need to know to get someone's opinion. Shall we go? Just a minute. I am not ready yet. So that means, shall we go? Are you ready to go? Or are you ready to come with me? So this is the question. So to get someone's opinion or offers or suggestion, we use shall. Then the next one is the use of be going to or is am are or was were plus going to. When is am are is added or is or am or are is added with going to, we can see that it is used to say about a colored future. A colored future usually can reflect a person's opinion, wish or intention of or some future arrangements, a plan of future thing. All these things can be set with the help of going to. Then first use we can see that to talk about the future intention, decision or arrangements. Let's see some example. We have run out of milk. That is said by a person. The second one answers, I know, I'm going to buy it. This is what the arrangement I am going to do. Then Anne is going to work in place of Joe next week. So that is an arrangement. That decision is already taken. If the decision is to be said, then it will be said in simple present tense. Anne works in place of Joe next week. So if the arrangement is to be said or planning that is already done, that planning is to be stated, that will be stated with the help of going to. Are you going to watch a film tonight? So do you have a plan to watch a film tonight? This is what the question. Then she is going to buy a new car. She has a plan to buy a new car. This is what the thing. Then next one, to make a prediction about the future. To predict something in that is going to happen in future. We can see, look at those boys playing football. They are going to break the window. So something that may happen because they have a history of breaking windows earlier. So that's why now we say that. So they are going to break the window. They are gonna break. Actually, if it is said in the case of what you can say American English. Then the sky is getting darker and darker. It's going to rain. So there is a possibility of rain. So it's going to rain. So the chance is said over there. So when we say with the help of going to or will or may or can, there are certain cases that we can see it is different. If you say that it is going to rain, that means there is a chance of rain because the present situation is like that. Evaluating the present situation, you say a future chance by using going to. If you say that it will rain, so that it will rain or it may rain. In this case, we can see that will is said with the case that future prediction, future chance is there. But if you use may, there the hope or the positive hope of the person is expressed. That means I intend to have a rain. So that's what is the thing. But if you say it can rain, that means so the person is least affected by whether it will rain or not. So this is the same case. We can see that when we going to is used, by the time it gives a prediction. Then the next one is the form of simple future along with subject will or shall. As I said earlier, shall is used with I and we. With the rest of the subjects we use will. The base form of the verb is used. Then we can see some examples. I shall do my work. Then I will do my work. I shall do my work is a normal case. I will do my work is considered to be a promise. Then she shall do it, something that is compulsory. It is necessary for her to do the work, or a promise. I promise for her that she is able to do that, or she can do it. Then she will do it. That is symbol possibility of future. Let's see the form of this tense. I shall or we shall do it, or she or he will do it, considered to be positive or affirmative sentence. If it is negative, I won't do it, I shan't do it, or we shan't do it, or she won't come tomorrow. Then if it is or she will not come, or I shall not do, that also can be used. Then if we take the case of interrogative, we can see that shall or will is to be placed before the subject. Then shall we do it or will she come tomorrow? If you want to place, if you want to make a WH question, then add what, where, when, how, or any of these question words in front of the shall or will, then the sentence changes to question, WH question. Shall we do it? What shall we do? Then or when shall we do it? Or how shall we do it? We can make the questions like that. If you want to make negative interrogative or the negative question, we have to add shan't or even won't. Otherwise, we have to just add shall, not with the verb or just in front of the verb. Shall we not do it or shan't we do it? Then why shall we not do it or why shan't we do it? So this is the end of the class. Thank you for watching this video. I would like to wish you a great day, and please share, like and subscribe our channel. Thank you.